Hello everyone, welcome back. Spring has come and I've managed to get out in it. The last time I've actually managed to get out was when I was with Richard, which was by chance a month ago today. And I've been longing to get out ever since. And here I am. Just a few hours I have spare before going to work, but it'll do me. Just needed to reconnect with nature. A couple of reasons that I've come out is all around me here, tucked in the vegetation, is a lot of wild garlic, and I love the stuff, and I've got a few plans with it which I will put in at the end of this video. Should probably be a bit of me doing things in my kitchen at home. And also, there are quite a lot of cramp balls in this woods, and so it's a good place to harvest them. I'm also going to have a quick brew, just because that's a great thing to do while it's out and about, and I'm just going to soak this up for a little while before I get busy doing a few bits of foraging. Well, I really enjoyed that, but time is against me, so it's time to get on with some foraging. Incidentally, I'm currently working on some foraging pouches to go on my Etsy store. There's been a bit of a delay because the sewing machine has had a part come off of it, and I don't think it's repairable, so it might be I have to get a new one, but we'll see. But when I do get them out, I will make an announcement on my Instagram and Facebook and all the rest, and they'll be available for all you guys to purchase. Right, let's get on with it. So there's quite a bit of wild garlic around here, which I'm gonna harvest bits of. I don't wanna take all from one spot, and I'm gonna be very careful because there's a lot of other stuff that's growing in between it. And there's a lot of bluebells coming up now, and I have seen some lords and ladies. I do always check it when I get home anyway, before I do anything with it. But I always try to avoid picking anything else while I'm here. And again, I take from different areas so I don't deprive anything, and it will grow back again next year. That's more than enough for what I need. That should keep me going for quite a long time. I've got a few bits and pieces I need to do with it at home, which I'll show later. But now I have to, unfortunately, head off and go to work and hope I don't stink the car out with this. Right, welcome to the family kitchen. I'm gonna be using the wild garlic I got the other day, and I'm making garlic salt. So a couple of things
that you'll need. One is wild garlic, two is about 250 grams of salt, and there's a few bits of equipment which will make this easier. One is a blender, and the other is, well, I've got a dehumidifier, but you can use an oven on a low temperature, or you can just lay it out on a windowsill in warm weather, and that should do it. So I'm going to wash the garlic and pull out anything that may not be garlic that I might have picked by accident, although I was fairly careful at the time, and get rid of some stems, any bits that may have just gone a bit bad, and go from there. One thing about doing this, it does get very smelly. When I use this dehumidifier, I have to literally put it by an open door at the back of the house, because otherwise it stinks the house out, and plus it permeates into absolutely everything, so it's better to do it outside if you can, or just let it dry naturally. Well, not quite 100 grams there, but that'll do. I now need to start blending it up. I'm going to add the salt now, and just a spoonful of it to get it started. Don't add it all at once, otherwise it just tends to clump. Do a little bit at a time. All right, that's the last of it. Quite well mixed, but I'm just going to scrape it off the sides, make sure that it gets really mixed up, but you're getting this really nice coloured sort of paste, crumbly paste. All right, there we go. That's that done. I'm now going to put this aside for a little while I sort the dehydrator out, ready for laying it all out. I'm going to be using greaseproof paper, which is ideal for this. And I normally find, for me, two trays on my dehydrator is ample. We're all ready now to start laying it out. And the idea is you want to get it as thinly as possible. I'm just going to stack these up now. Like so. I might even put a spacer in the middle to give it a bit more airflow, and I'll put it on. This has had roughly 3 hours now, and it's all just breaking up nicely. It's very crumbly. So, last job is to take it off the sheet and put it in the jar. Well, there we go. This will keep probably for 6 months or more if you keep the lid on. and I like to use it on in various dishes and things. Just nearly everything we have when we're cooking, we just sprinkle a little bit in over the top. Yeah, lovely taste and very easy to do. Well, I hope you enjoyed that and found it useful, and hopefully see you on the next one. Cheers.
Excuse me.